high atop Mount Umanam, in Midpen's Sierra Azul Open Space Preserve, a team of biologists are searching for the charming but elusive Santa Cruz kangaroo rat.
Okay, 64A looks empty, but 64B is closed, so we're gonna check it. I think I can feel somebody in there. Yep, there's a kangaroo rat.
These cute critters with a funny name are actually a keystone species, helping maintain balance in the chaparral habitat, but their very presence here was shrouded in mystery.
We did not know that Santa Cruz kangaroo rats were up here until 2019. So this is a very recent discovery for us.
Kangaroo rats are just one of many species, like purple marten, mountain lion, and bobcat, that make their home here. And like the very mountain itself, are making a comeback.
Just goes to show, like, protecting lands is incredibly important because not only are you protecting the species that you know are there, there may be something there that's a complete mystery and a complete surprise that you are then also protecting.
Mid-Peninsula Regional Open Space District protects 70,000 acres across 27 preserves throughout the greater Santa Cruz Mountains region. From coastal prairies to redwood forests, oak woodlands, and bay wetlands. But standing high above them all is Sierra Azul Open Space Preserve.
There's a lot of things that make Sierra Azul a unique preserve. But number one is it's just sheer size. It's massive, not only in acreage, but in elevation.
At 3,400 feet tall, Mount Umanam defines the Sierra Azul skyline. It's a local landmark that can be seen from miles around. But up close, in the folds of its protected valleys, and on the exposed ridgelines with breathtaking views, the mountain's secrets are slowly being revealed.
As a space, it's very inspiring and it's extremely significant, and I'm really pleased to be working with a unique species as well that we find out here.
When we visited Mount back in 2013, the peak was littered with the abandoned remains of the old Alameda Air Station. In the years since, we've watched Midpen restore this mountaintop, bringing back some of its natural shape and welcoming back the original stewards and the public. Midpen also restored the native habitat, with scores of volunteers gently planting tender roots into rocky soil. And as the plants are reclaiming this mountaintop, so too are the animals. Local photographer and ecologist Ken Hickman has been helping Midpen document the diversity of wildlife that finds sanctuary on these protected lands. His photos capture moments of curiosity, play, and rest.
Ken Hickman is just a really great individual and a very, very determined person who came into Midpen about 10 years ago and basically said, hey, I'm really interested in finding rare and unusual species that haven't been found in the Santa Cruz Mountains for many, many decades.
With a permit from Midpen and a background in engineering, Ken designed and built custom wildlife cameras and placed them strategically in the preserve. His photos reveal species both familiar and rare, like the Santa Cruz kangaroo rat, whose presence in the area had been noted long ago, but hadn't been seen in the area in over 75 years.
It wasn't an instant success story. It took a lot of work, a lot of diligence to find them. But yeah, when he finally did and we saw those photos, we were awestruck. And we were so excited to have an opportunity to help this species out and to just know that we had them on our lands.
Santa Cruz kangaroo rats are an endemic species found only in the Santa Cruz Mountains. They're actually not rats. They're more closely related to chipmunks. Their seed caches help manzanitas continue to thrive, and their burrows provide shelter for toads, snakes, and other animals. They're a keystone species, and Ken's photos provided proof that they're still here.
Here at Midpen, we take that kind of thing very seriously. Obviously, we got very excited about it. But the first question for us was, you know, where are they? How do we document where they are on the landscape? And then, is there anything we need to do management-wise to change our practices to make sure that they stay on the landscape?
To answer those questions, and many others, Midpen partnered with biologists from the University of California, Santa Cruz, to study this newfound population.
Got two, three, empty, empty.
Two, seven is empty.
Today we
empty.
Deployed about 200 Sherman traps. They're metal steel traps that we use to catch small mammals. These ones are kangaroo at length for the comfort and safety of the animal. We go ahead and bait them at about sunset, and then we check them at sunrise before it gets too hot.
The traps allow researchers to briefly capture this hard-to-find species and collect valuable data.
We're taking veg data, we're taking morphometrics, so their body length, ear length, tail length, everything like that.
This study is helping paint a picture of the whole environment, from the type of plants that kangaroo rats prefer to the other species that live here too.
We have a pinion mouse. This is Paramiscus treei. It's hard to tell, but when you're mice people like we are and we stare at mice all day, you can really tell.
The team catches a variety of mice and other small mammals, noting their presence and releasing them back into the wild to go about their lives.
So we have here a San Francisco dusky-footed wood rat, which is actually a species of special concern here in California. But it's also kind of an interesting sign here in this carrot habitat to find a wood rat because, as the name implies, wood rats tend to be in more forested areas. So it's kind of a sign that this habitat is changing through time and becoming more forested and less open.
More pine trees and wood rats means less chaparral habitat, the open environment Santa Cruz kangaroo rats depend on.
If you don't have regular fire intervals in places like this, the chaparral eventually does go away and it closes up. So in the absence of those fire regimes, we need to think about other potential strategies for keeping this area open.
After 3 days of trapping, they only found four individuals. A reminder of just how rare Santa Cruz kangaroo rats are, and how important this research is for understanding and ultimately protecting them.
It is a little disheartening because we are concerned about the population here and if they are thriving, if they are succeeding. And so getting little indicators like that might tell us that they're not doing as great, and that makes us feel much more urgent that we need to push things forward. These kangaroo rats need help now. And we can do that. We can help them.